Hello people, welcome back to my channel. So we all know that decision trees built or constructed based on recursive partitioning algorithm. So Hund's algorithm is one such tree induction algorithm which is based on recursive partitioning in order to build your decision tree. So today's video is regarding the Hund's algorithm, so let's begin. So Hund's algorithm grows a decision tree in a recursive fashion by partitioning the training records into more and more purer subsets. So we know that our data set is divided into training set and test set. So majority of the portion goes into training set and a few portion goes into test set. So with the training record, we induce the Hund's algorithm. So Hund's algorithm is necessarily a tree induction algorithm. So it's a decision tree induction algorithm. So say for example, you have this representation. So DT represents the training records at node T. So node in decision tree is represented in this way. So to this you apply training records for constructing your decision tree. So what Hund's algorithm says is that if your training record has same class label, means all the records, say for example, all the records have positive class label or all the record have negative class label, then what you do is you just change this node T into leaf node and label it as YT. Means if T is positive, then you represent it as Y plus, or if T is negative, you represent it as Y minus. So this becomes a leaf node. Second is that if your training record is empty, training record is an empty set. Sometimes this case can happen. So in that instance, what you do is you again represent your T as leaf node, means in this way, and what you assign is label it as default class and it's labeled as YD. So whichever is a default class, it goes to this. Now if your training record consists of multiple classes, that is heterogeneous class labels, then what you do is you call a attribute test condition to split. So we have different types of attributes in machine learning. So our basic type of attribute is binary attribute. So you have yes, no, or say for example, you have spam or not spam. So what it does is it does a two-way split. And then what you have is nominal attributes. So it can be name, first name, middle name, something like this. So for this again, you do a multi-way split. Next, what you have is ordinal attributes. So this can be like high school, middle school, or something like that. So for this, what you do is you do a two-way split or you either perform a multi-way split by grouping it into two subsets or two groups. Then what you have is continuous attributes. Say for example, you have an employee data set and in that different employees in different designations have salary, that is their annual income. So that is a continuous attribute. So in that, what you do is you convert it into a range. So say for example, you have employees with salaries less than equal to 87.5K or greater than, that is 87.5K. So in this, what you do, you construct a multi-way split or a binary split, whichever is possible. Okay, So this is the way how the data is splitted if you have heterogeneous class labels. Now there is one assumption. What the assumption is basically that if you have different attributes, so the attribute combination can have unique class labels, or it can only have unique class labels. So just consider you have class label of attribute 1 and you just combine with attribute 2 and attribute 3. So this class label is not equal to the class label of, say, you have attribute 1 into attribute 2 into attribute 4. So this assumption Hund's algorithm basically follows. And then what you have is, if you have the attribute values and it all has the same value, so if all the attribute values are basically same, then this algorithm states that it is atomic, that is, it cannot be divided furthermore. So that's where this algorithm stops. So in that case, what you do is you assign the T node as leaf node and you assign the label as the majority class. So say you have 11 instances and out of this you have 6 instances as positive and 5 instances as negative. So whichever is the majority, you assign a label of that class. So what is the stopping criteria of Hund's algorithm, or when the tree induction algorithm stops? So that is a very vital condition in order to stop any tree growing algorithm. And why? Because since it's recursive, it can just continuously speed up your memory and can obtain many space. So there is one stopping criteria. Stopping criteria is basically that one I've discussed, that if the attribute values are same, then it's not further divided. So that is one. And second condition is that if all records belong to same class labels, so after you partition into more and more subsets, and if all the records belong to same class labels, then this algorithm basically stops. So well, that was all regarding the Hund's algorithm in machine learning. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you found it educative watching this video, please do like, share, comment, and most importantly, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much for watching this video.